And we're back. If you've been following along from last year, you would have seen how do we do it at Hyperdrive, where I was learning to race our regular adult karts way better than I could possibly race them. I started off doing about 46 seconds around our enduro track, and the team here at Hyperdrive and our best racers gave me tips all along the way until I got good enough to do a 43 second lap, which I thought was pretty good. But now we're going to go from learning to race our regular adult karts better to learning to race these super shifter karts better. These karts are way faster. They've got paddle shift gears, they've got a diff in the back, so they're a little bit less forgiving than these straight axled regular adult karts, and they generally just go a lot faster. I'm already sitting at about 43 seconds a lap. I want to get onto the leaderboard in the super shifter karts, and to do that, I'm going to need to beat a 40.3 seconds. To get there, it's going to take me weeks. I'm going to get lots of tips along the way. To help me today, to give me some basic tips before I get started, is the guy who is on the top of the leaderboard. One of our crew here, Callum, he races proper petrol karts. He's a real go-kart gun, but he's going to give me some basic tips right now.
How you doing?
I'm not too bad, how are you?
You are on the top of the leaderboard in the super shifter kart.
Yeah, both at the moment.
So what is your time for the super shifter karts?
Yesterday I did a 38.9.
38.9, wowee, that is so fast. I just want to get into the low 40 flat. So if I can beat that and get onto the leaderboard, I'm going to feel pretty good about myself.
Yep.
It's not going to happen today, that's for sure.
It's a long process, but I can definitely see you getting up on that leaderboard. You're very, very close.
Have you got any tips for me today before I go out?
Maximize the whole length of the track. Make sure you're going out nice and wide, cutting in. Just be nice and smooth on the steering wheel in general.
So it's come down the outside, brake as late as possible without skidding out too much, of course. Go to the inside of the corner here and carry as much speed through so we can take off and take the rest of the track as fast as we can.
Yes, correct. It just means that you can carry a lot more speed throughout the corners.
Carrying speed, that's a real trick, isn't it?
Yes, especially with these shifters.
See how I go. Make sure I stay out wide, brake, come into the corner, hit that, not too bad. Whoa. In the 43s,
yep.
I got down to the low 42s, so yep. I managed to shave off a little bit of time while I'm out there.
Yeah, you smash it out there, but that is still my warm-up lap.
Rub it in. I'll get better, don't you worry. I've got heaps of questions for you.
Yeah, of course.
There's heaps more for me to learn, so I'm really excited to talk to you some more, and some of the other guys here as well, about getting better in these shifter karts, and I'm really looking forward to getting up onto that leaderboard. So thanks for your tips today.
No worries at all.
We'll see you back here on how we do it at Hyperdrive, where I learned to race the shifter karts better, and you can pick up on the tips that I learned to get you better in the shifter karts too.
There we go.
Awesome.